Kashmir's Wazwan is famous all over the world, but besides Wazwan, there are a lot more food options you can explore when in Kashmir. In this video, we are going to take you on an exclusive food journey of this beautiful valley. From the world-famous Wazwan to the local everyday food, it is going to be a journey of a lifetime. Hello everyone, I'm Anubhav Sapra from Delhi Food Walks. We are starting our Kashmir food excursion from Chashme Shahi. That translates into Royal Spring. There are three Mughal gardens in Srinagar, the others being Nishat and Shalimar Bagh. Here I am with Nazwa, who will be taking us on a food journey in Kashmir. Let's go and explore. A valley located amongst the great Himalayas, Kashmir or Kashmir is a mesmerizing place. From its snow-clad mountain peaks to its lush green meadows, everything is breathtakingly beautiful, which is perhaps why Emperor Jahangir referred to it as the paradise on earth. Although Kashmir is well known for its beauty, the people of Kashmir are equally famous for their hospitality. While the beauty of Kashmir has been thoroughly explored by the people from all corners of the world, the local cuisine has largely remained unexplored except the Wazwan. Our Kashmir food journey started with a visit to the famous floating market of the Dal Lake. Srinagar's Dal Lake is famous all over the world for its scenic location and the shikaras that float on it, but for the Dal dwellers, this lake is their home, their livelihood, as well as the source of their sustenance. The famous floating vegetable market of the lake is one of its kind in India and only the second in the world, the other being the rowing shops along the backwaters of the Mekong Delta in Vietnam. To visit the market, we left quite early in the morning as this market closes just before sunrise. The boatmen with their boats laden with the flowers and vegetables produced in and around the floating gardens of the Dal gather here every morning to sell their produce. The hustle bustle is exactly as you would expect in any vegetable market, and the produce being sold varies with each season. We have finally entered the floating vegetable market in Dal Lake, and you can see like what's happening around here.
All the action is around the vegetables from the Dal. Mm-hmm. So all the people have gotten them in their own boats and they are selling it so that then they can take it to the mainland and sell it to the people there. So the highest bidder gets the better vegetables.
So the bidding is happening here.
Yeah.
Okay, and can we see like what all vegetables they have it?
Yeah, they have haak. They have all the typical Kashmiri vegetables. They have monja haak, monja haak, and they have nadru.
Okay.
And they have some coriander also.
So we are buying some vegetables from the floating market.
Bas?
We have got some coriander and mojak.
Manjak.
Manjak.
And you can see the flowers also. Like for cultivation, then you can just buy the plants.
As per our Shikarawala, the peak season is summer when there is a huge selection of vegetables around.
Yeah.
You can see it's blacker in color, the cumin.
Yeah, yeah. This cumin, black cumin, is almost like 4,000 rupees a kilogram.
Yeah, then you have honey. Also. This is almond oil, like pressed almonds, walnut oil. So he sells these things every day.
So this is a market where you can come, you can get your vegetables, then you have spices.
You can get those also.
All of them.
Yeah, he is even selling creams.
Surrounded by the calm, dull waters with the morning light just peeking through the curtain of darkness, the floating market is a sight to behold. Yeah. Why is the vegetable more popular of Dal Lake?
So because it's grown on natural fertilizer. Like the plants, the weeds growing in Dal, Azolla, and they pull them out and then they stack them. You can see those small stacks there.
Yeah, I can
so
see that.
So they grow the vegetables on that. So the thing is that this weed, I mean this natural fertilizer, it pulls out water from below. So they don't need to water the vegetables. And because the sunlight is above, so the vegetable keeps hanging. It doesn't also fall down. So it doesn't touch the land. And also they can move it to, like they can just pick it up along with the vegetable growing in it.
Okay, some
and
other,
put it some other place. So the fertilizer there also, this fertilizer, it will keep pulling water from the down. So that is the benefit. They don't need to water it also. And the vegetable doesn't fall down.
So the vegetable which we get here is more delicious.
It's more succulent, you can say. Yeah. Because it's grown on natural, there is no use of chemical fertilizers or anything like that.
While returning back from the floating market, we came across a kandoor shop selling freshly baked local breads.
Wow, it's so fresh, and again with the poppy seeds.
Yeah. It will be very fresh.
After our visit to the floating market, we were invited to breakfast by Mr. Yakub Dunu, a houseboat owner and a fabulous host. Surrounded by the pristine waters of the adjoining Nigen Lake, we had our first taste of traditional Kashmiri breakfast.
When the Britishers came here, they were just coming for enjoying their holidays as a summer vacation. So what did they say? वो तो लॉज कर रहे थे हिंदुस्तान में यहाँ पे आके उन्होंने सोचा कि हम लैंड पे रहे तो उस टाइम के जमाने के जो महाराजा थे उन्होंने उनको रिजेक्ट कर दिया वही आर्टिकल 370 तो उसी की वजह से उनके दिमाग में आ गया उन्होंने छोटा सा हाउस बोट बनाया तो जो सबसे पहला हाउस बोट बना दैट वॉज इन 1888 बाय सर कॉनॉट तो कॉनॉट के दिमाग में आ गया उन्होंने शिप टाइप का छोटा सा हाउस बोट बनाया जिसका लिविंग सिटिंग बेडरूम एक ही था यानी एक बेडरूम फिर उसके बाद सिटिंग और डाइनिंग टाइम उसी को थोड़ा अपग्रेड करके हमने
धीरे धीरे हाउस बोट बन गया देयर इज द होल स्टोरी अबाउट लाइक हाउ द हाउस बोट स्टार्टेड हियर सो ब्रिटिशर्स व्हेन दे यूज्ड टू कम हियर दे वर नॉट अलाउड टू लिव ऑन द लैंड हियर इन कश्मीर दैट्स व्हाई दे स्टार्टेड दिस कांसेप्ट ऑफ हाउस बोट एंड नाउ इट्स अ फुल फ्लेज्ड टूरिज्म एंड पीपल आर लिविंग हियर देयर होल लाइफस्टाइल द कम्युनिटी
वी हैड टी विद गिरदा अ टाइप ऑफ कश्मीरी ब्रेड कंज्यूम्ड इन द मॉर्निंग After our breakfast, Mr. Dunno showed us around his houseboat. The intricate handmade walnut carvings inside the houseboat and the mesmerizing water surrounding it was a sight to behold.
So that was an incredible experience. We in the morning we first visited the floating vegetable market and then we ended with a visit to houseboat and we had a traditional Kashmiri breakfast with Gidda. Butter, jam and the chai.
Yeah.
So it was a beautiful experience and we really enjoyed it.
It was a breakfast modified to the taste of tourists.
Tourists. We got some perfume packed and some vegetables like we are having, still carrying it. You can see that's haak and we have some fresh coriander. So it was a great experience.
After a tour of Dunno Saab's houseboat, we set out to explore the famous University of Kashmir located in Hazrat Bal and to satisfy our cravings for a hot cup of adrak wali chai.
The best food and the most reasonable food you get is in the university. That's why we are at Kashmir University going to try chicken kanti. So we have ordered chicken kanti here at Kashmir University in the university cafeteria and that's Najwa's favorite
chicken kanti
in Kashmir. So we are trying the chicken kanti with naan. Wow, it was really good.
Just outside one of the three gates of the university, called as the Rumi Gate, sits a masal soat cellar. Masal soat is a traditional Kashmiri street food snack. For this snack, lavasa, another type of Kashmiri flatbread, is stuffed with a boiled chickpea paste, which is topped with a spicy reddish chutney and curd. Priced at just rupees 10, this is a perfect snack to grab in a hurry.
How spicy it looks with the red chilies and all, and this is the matar. So, we'll try it. It's spicy.
Yeah, it is spicy.
It's really spicy for me.
After the slightly spicy masal soat, it was time to try something sweet. Just outside the Sir Sayyid Gate of Kashmir University, we found a very old and a famous shop which sells walnut fudges, a type of walnut pastry prepared from Kashmiri walnuts and honey.
Wow! Good! It's super delicious! I was worried that in Srinagar people don't eat sweets at all. But we found this shop and they make, I think I've tried the best walnut fudge I had ever tried. They use only three ingredients in making this. They have walnuts, honey and dates. That's it. There's no sugar in it. And it's quite moist and gooey. So you can see it's very, very, very moist and gooey from inside. So that's how they are made. If they bake it for almost
40 minutes, the mixture, the entire preparation takes them around 15 hours.
15 hours. So the entire preparation of this walnut pulp, it takes almost 15 hours to make it. So if you are in Srinagar and if you try some desserts or sweets, I will highly recommend to come to this place at Moonlight Bakery in Hazratbal and try their walnut fudge. Super delicious, super yum.
After relishing the delicious walnut fudge, for lunch we went to have our first taste of the world famous Kashmiri Wazwan.
So we are going to Karima restaurant. It is not that popular restaurant amongst the tourists, and here we are going to try the mini Wazwan.
Located in a quiet street in Lal Chowk, is a favorite among the locals. The restaurant is famous for its mini Wazwan plate, a rice plate served in a traditional Wazwan style.
This is kebab, this is meth mas, and this is called as tabak mas.
So
this is the only thing in Wazwan that's fried in ghee.
Tabak mas?
Yeah, this and is ribs. They are braised in water and then they are fried in ghee.
And what is
this? Is made from tripe. Sheep stomach.
Okay.
And then dried fenugreek is added in this.
That's why they call it methi.
Yeah, we call it methi mas. Mas as in meat.
And that's served with meat balls, that's what we call rista. So I'm so starting with it.
Methi mas and rice. So you can see how crispy it is. Yeah. The skin, the fat on the top.
Yeah.
They're very crispy.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's deep fried.
Yeah.
So it's first braised so that it becomes soft.
Yeah, because it's very, very crisp.
Mm-hmm. They will serve it one by one because traditionally in Wazwan, the dishes, the waza comes and keeps pouring on new dishes into the trami.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why they will serve it like that. So then you can like have a rista.
Mm-hmm.
Since you got rista.
It's really good.
Yeah, piece of the rista.
Mm-hmm. Then mix
it. This is the minced meatball.
This is a minced meatball.
It's like the most tender part of the animal which the meat has come from, like the sheep.
Mm-hmm.
So then they hand pound it.
Okay.
Typically in Wazwan, like nothing is very spicy because it's a huge gathering. So you have to cater to everybody's taste buds.
Okay.
So the salt will also be very well balanced.
Mm-hmm.
The spice level will also be like not on the higher side.
Mm-hmm.
Like as per the taste, so that everybody can enjoy.
The tabak mas is like with a big layer of fat on it.
Yeah, it has to have a
has
big
fat
layer
on
of
it.
Fat.
Yeah.
Because they fry it, that layer
the
becomes
ribs.
Crispy.
Yeah, that's a.
So there is a special cut. Like you have to go to the butcher and ask, I'm making tabak mas at home. Even if you want to prepare it at home,
uh-huh.
So it'll be like, I'm making tabak mas.
Mm-hmm.
So now he's serving us another dish. So this is mutton rogan josh.
Wow.
I can try this
one. Wow. This is a very big piece. You can serve this side. Yeah. So this course by course, they serve you different kinds of meat dishes.
Yeah.
First was methi, then you have kebabs, then kebab mas, then we had rista. Now rogan josh.
Yeah. So like with rista, you get an individual rista. Like if you are having four people in a tram, so every person gets their own rista.
Okay.
So the waza will put four ristas in the tram.
Mm.
But the gushtava, like it's a very big meatball.
Okay.
So then the waza will only put one meatball and then gravy on all the four sides.
Okay.
And then you have to cut that.
So you
in
make your own
pieces.
Compartment in Mantrami and then you start sharing from them.
So you can see the size is bigger. But here since you're having individual thali, so it's individual portion here. But otherwise like in a proper traditional wazwan, the gushtava will be very big so that you can cut it into four pieces.
Okay. There's the last dish of the wazwan. Then you can see meatball cooked in yogurt based gravy, and this signifies the end of the wazwan.
This is very hot.
It's very hot.
It's steaming hot because the yogurt, it's a yogurt based.
Yeah, that's why I cut it. So that's the gushtava. It's quite soft, very succulent, and again not spicy because it's yogurt based one. And there are a lot of is ghee?
Gravy. No, not ghee.
What is
like
it?
They cook it for so long, all the oil, it seeps to the top.
Okay.
Like this is the indication that it's a well-cooked gravy.
Everything was good. I really like, my favorite one was, if you ask me, my favorite was gushtava and kebab. I like both of them.
Okay.
Even rogan josh is very special. The main part for me is like everything is like not super spicy. It's mild in flavor.
Yeah, it's toned down to suit everybody's.
Every palate. We really had an amazing meal at Karima restaurant in Lal Chowk. Here we tried the mini Wazwan. This is like a mini thali where you get rice and you start with methi mas, then you have kebabs, rogan josh, rista, tabakamas, and you end the meal with koshtava. That's like you end a meal. It's cooked in a yogurt based sauce. And I liked it very much. If you are in Srinagar anytime, you can come to this place and try the mini Wazwan.
Next, we went to try Kulfi at Dil Bahar Kulfi, a famous shop located in the Goni Khan market.
So, ye hai.
This is a very popular shop. And you can see like how they are making it. They put milk in this different molds, and then you have ice box and they frozen down that side.
After our refreshing kulfi, it was time to visit the Hazrat Bal Friday Market, or Dargah Market as the locals call it. Hazrat Bal, which translates into Sacred Bank, is famous for its Hazrat Bal Shrine, one of the holiest Muslim shrines in Kashmir. The shrine, which contains the holy relic Moye Muqaddas, believed to be the hair of Prophet Muhammad, is located on the left bank of the Dal Lake, hence the name. The place is thronged by devotees every Friday who, besides praying, also come to buy a variety of items which are hard to find on an everyday basis. Every Friday, local vendors and people from far off places come to sell a variety of items in the market. If you want a glimpse of the traditional Kashmir, this is the place to visit. The first thing we tried was masal, a popular street food snack which simply consists of boiled black beans sprinkled with a chili powder and salt mixture.
So we are having masal. This is our first thing which we are having in near Hazrat Bal food street. It's boiled black beans with chilies and salt. Again, not spicy.
Yeah, it's not spicy.
It's like a snack.
Yeah, just a little bit of chili, a little bit of fennel powder. They boil them without anything, just in plain water.
Next, we tried some nadr munj.
So they mix that.
Oh. So normally these are nadru, lotus stem, what we call kamal kakdi also, and they dip it in the batter of rice flour, then they are deep fried here.
Yeah, they are deep fried. It's big.
So this is the typical food around Dargah, where they make the paratha and halwa. It's a big, huge size paratha. Oh, you can see like how they are rolling it. This, the dough is made up of white flour. So it's rolled by his hand, like this, how they flip it up.
Yeah.
Wow.
Wow. Pans fixed in the clay ovens. So these are not portable.
There's a huge, big size parathas. Yeah. And you can see like how they are cooked. They're cooked over wood fire. That's done. Wow. We are going to try some halwa paratha. There's a fresh paratha. They just made it right here. And we are going to buy some of it. So we're just tasting it. So that's the halwa and paratha. We have just got the small piece because so full. But that's the paratha. That's made up of maida.
You take a little bit of paratha.
And then you put some halwa.
Take some halwa. And you can see it's piping hot because they made it fresh.
Yeah. So this is like a typical street food which you get around a Dargah. A big size paratha and halwa. You can buy it like small portions as well.
Yeah, you can buy small portions. You can take 50 rupees for 10 rupees, for 50 rupees. Yeah. So then you have it as well.
That's really good. Excellent. There are three different kinds of jeera, cumin. They are not roasted.
No, no.
It comes in this color and you eat it
straight away. Yeah, you can try it. And this is like a little bit bigger than that one. You can see the comparison.
Yeah.
And this is like
the normal one. Yeah, so here you have kulcha.
Yeah, you can see the size of these kulchas is much smaller.
Yeah, the one which we had was a bigger one.
Yeah, yeah, it was a bigger one. Yeah. So you have big girdas here, like very big. The Dargah girda.
And then they've added poppy seeds over it.
Just a little bit of poppy seed. And this is like the touchwood, but it's baked for a long time, so it's more crispy. More like kulcha, but it's covered with sesame seeds.
Okay.
So it's like, it's called as kripa.
Kripa?
Yeah, this is called as kripa.
Crip.
Yeah.
It's more crisp. That's why I think they call it crisp.
Yeah, yeah, because it breaks, it makes a crisp sound.
Yeah,
that's why.
And then they put some sesame seeds over it. Let's try it out.
have it with noon chai, like you dip it in noon chai.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so when you add it in moon chai, it becomes a bit soft and then you can try.
You can eat it. So this roll very thin and then baked. So it's flaky. If you break it open, it's
like
very
a
flaky.
Puff pastry.
Yeah. So this bagir khani, there are two types of. One bagir khani, it's made by bakery people.
Mm-hmm.
So the bagir khani there is bigger. So this is made by kandur. Like they don't add any ghee in this. So this is kandur bagir khani.
Kandur bagir khani.
You can try this one.
Okay. Let's try this. Like bakir khani. It's crisp like a puff pastry.
Kandur burger.
Kandur burger.
There is another one which you take to other places, like you're going somewhere.
Uh-huh.
So you'll take those burger khani.
Wow.
So they are prepared specially by these bakery people. So they will add ghee or oil in that.
Okay.
So this has no ghee, nothing.
Mm.
You can see the layers.
The same thing which we call fan. We have something called fan.
Uh-huh.
It's like a puff pastry. And you soak it in tea.
And
you have it like that.
So it becomes soft when you put it in tea, then you have it with the spoon.
So this is the place where you get big size pedals
and for stirring. Yeah. Like they're used by Wazas in Wazwan.
Mm-hmm.
So because the Wazwan is mass production of food, so they use big pots and big chochas to
stir. So those who are buying this, they all are Wazas.
Yeah, probably they will have something to do with mass production.
Okay.
And you see those round things.
Uh-huh.
Like, and that's, that is what they use as
that's for use for pounding the meat, like missing the meat. It's like a big hammer.
Yeah. For this they will use a stone tuck.
Gotcha.
So that when they pound it, mm-hmm. easily mince ho jayega. Mm-hmm.
We tried homemade cow butter, which was hand churned and sold in ball shapes. Next to the guy selling the homemade butter, we found a local lady selling Kashmiri mixed pickle made from haak, nadru and carrots. After the mouth-numbing pickle, it was time to try some local sweets like khand gazar, busrak and lal shangram. All these snacks are made from flour and sugar. The busrak and khand gazar are coated with a thick layer of sugar syrup, while the lal shangram has some semolina added to it. Next, we tried shangram, which is fried sweet dough.
So they are using dara oil.
Uh-huh.
Or refined atta, like
Acha.
Some maida,
uh-huh.
and a little bit of sugar.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah. Not very sweet, according to our taste.
What is it called?
Shangram.
Shangram.
Yeah. It's also very popular. Mm. You can see people are lining
up. Yeah, I can see the kids having it.
Yeah. Mm. Kids love it.
It's called nadru. You can call it lotus stem or kamal kakri or bhe. This is like a big part of Kashmir cuisine. They make it. There's only like a couple of dishes where they eat a vegetarian food. It's nadru and haak. Wow, that was a very interesting and amazing experience exploring the bylanes of Hazratbal Shrine. We tried so many street food delicacies. I can't say you that there are so many things to try apart from the famous Wazwan of Kashmiri cuisine.
After an extensive tour of the Dargah market, it was time to satisfy our barbecue cravings.
So we are on Khayyam Street. We are going to have the Kashmiri barbecue that's called Tuj.
Yeah.
A place which is quite well known for its meat barbecue skewers, which the locals refer to as Tuj. The place is truly a barbecue lover's heaven, for you can find an entire street full of shops selling tuj and a variety of other barbecued meats. We had our first taste of the chewy yet juicy mutton tuj at Garib Nawaz, a place that has been serving tuj for more than 4 decades. The mutton skewer was served with a variety of yogurt-based chutneys or dips and the local flatbread called lavasa.
Piece of lavasa, okay.
Mm-hmm.
So what you do is just pull out one, mm-hmm. okay. Then you take your choice of chutney,
mm-hmm.
and you roll it and you have it. Yeah. So you take it with your piece of chutney, your choice of chutney. You can take any one, and then you have it. Yeah, exactly. Option.
Done. It's gone.
I just took a lot of it.
Mm-hmm.
then you leave it. I said it's pure barbecued meat. It's not.
This, like, whatever people are having is more like an evening snack for them.
Yeah, yeah, it's like an evening.
They will have
snack.
Their dinner again.
This is not dinner.
Even with the bread we are having.
It's like an evening snack.
So if you are in Srinagar, you can come to this place in Khayyam called Garib Nawaz Cafeteria. In the evening, they have tuj. There's barbecued mutton, and which you get with 6 different kinds of dips and lavasa bread.
All in all, it was a day well spent. Please stay tuned for our next video, in which we will take you on an exclusive journey of the breads of Kashmir as well as taste of a traditional home-cooked Kashmiri meal.